Channels are objects in Beyond that can store data. This is either raw 8-bit data in the case of regular channels, or color data in color channels. These values can be used as input and outputs for various reasons and throughout various ways in the software. This allows users to connect one set of data to others, allowing for external control, variable values, live inputs of normally static data, and more. You can find channels in the UI in the right tab area. On the top left, you first have Channels Setup. This is for regular non-color channels. Here you can name channels, change their color in the UI, set default physics, default binding to DMX, audio frequencies, and the virtual DJ frequency blending mode. Next to Channel Setup, you can enable the Channel Mixer. If you're using channels with more than one input of any of these four, you can set priority and mix level. Channel at 100 and the rest at 0 means your manually set channel value will be used. If channel and DMX are 100%, then Beyond will take half from channels and half from the DMX input to mix together. Next to the mixer, you'll see the time mixer. If you're using channels as a speed variable, you can choose to mix in and out of the channel value to the default value in an effect. Color channels can be viewed by pressing this color wheel icon to the right. Color channels can be accessed by this UI. Color channels act similarly to regular channels except store color data, and that can be referenced where color data is called upon. You can see all of your color channels to the left and edit those channels on the right. First, you can name your channel, set its mode, whether it's manual, webcam pixel color, or timeline video color. When manually setting the color, you can pick the color using the color wheel and triangle. These channels are also objects in the object tree, so you can be controlled and valued just like any object in the tree. Regular channels can be grabbed under channels, and then specify the number for the channel. Note, 0 is the first channel in this case. Color channels can be found under the color channel group. You can select the array, noting again that 0 is the first color channel. Color channels contain more than just a single value, as you can see those data points here. For most people, the primary use will be for RGB, but you can switch modes and move the positioning and video around as well via the object. Watch the Object Tree Quick Hints video and Object Animator Quick Hints video and PangoScript Quick Hints video as well to learn more about how you can use this object data and control it. Now that we know how to get data into channels, let's get the data out and use it in different areas. For regular channels, you'll be able to see the channel data for a parameter when you see this icon. Let's use this size key effect to demonstrate. We will set the X and the Y to follow channels 1 and 2 and go from 0 to 100 value. Now you can see that these channels control the X and Y size parameters of the effect directly. This can open up a lot of opportunity, as most parameters in effects can be linked to channels. You could use channels as submasters, you could use the channels for master speed on your live effects, and pretty much whatever you can imagine. Now let's look at how color channels can be used. Here we have a very standard and simple color type color effect. Now instead of these colors being set, we can assign them to our color channels. The first key to be channel 1, the second key to channel 2, and the third key to channel 1. Once these color keys are assigned, you will see these little lines marking they are bound. Now we can change the color effect based on the color channel associated with each key. This can allow you to recolor effects by changing the actual color data of keys, opening up new ways of using effects never seen before. In a key color effect, where color channels can be used, you'll see an icon that looks like a color channel icon, which will then be able to control the RGB values associated with the effect from the color channels. Thanks for watching this quick hints video on channels and color channels in Beyond. If you still need help or have questions, feel free to contact us at support@penguin.com or check out our other videos or wiki, all linked below.